last time?
We were in
Glasgow.
Yeah.
And you were raising money for Indoor Pets.
We were, yeah. It was very good. Everyone there was really generous.
Yeah, so like obviously that was after the Manchester gig 2 days ago now?
Yeah.
Three days.
Yeah,
so obviously day off in between.
Yeah. Okay. So like Fender have come in now and played stuff, but did they play with any of your gear on?
No, so they couldn't play Glasgow. They stayed in Manchester trying to, I think they were going around to like pawn shops and stuff.
Yeah.
And basically like with a list of their stuff,
this happened too. There's a station, community station in Leeds called Kmart, and they had all of their stuff in it for a second time. And they managed to find it in a pawn shop, and the guy had sold like one of the CDJs, and they literally raced the car that it was in down to the shipping dock where it had been sent to, and like pulled it off the truck at the last minute.
Oh my god.
Stuff. Yeah, they chased it. It was mad.
Wow. That's crazy.
It's just like, it sucks at this level as well, because everything's kind of hand to mouth, and to lose. I mean, they've been collecting a lot of that gear for like 10 years or whatever, and it's quite a lot of money.
Yeah.
Money that they don't have to just replace it. So to target someone like that is just like...
You've been on tour almost solidly. You've been in festivals, started this tour off. Like, is this getting to a point where you don't have to have a bar job anymore? And...
Yeah, so we quit our jobs,
a year ago?
Yeah,
so around the time when the album campaign was like properly like...
Yeah, well, it was basically...
I think it was when Fresh came out.
So it was kind of just when we finished, just before we put out the first EP. But we sort of, that was just like a collection of singles we put out before.
The other guys still have to work like part-time jobs.
Okay.
Stuff, well, it's just like, I don't know. It sucks. And we're trying to work towards the point where we can all just focus on this.
Yeah, I was going to say, so obviously a lot of what you do is presented as the two of you as brothers, your songwriters, you do a thing. Can you walk us through who else is in the band and what they do?
Yeah. So in the live band, we've got Olivia Dimery on drums, Sam Hunt on bass, and Charlie Pitt on guitar. And they've been with us they're as much fans as we are, really.
That's what I mean, when you see you guys in press situations like this, it is just the two of you, but in a live setting, it is a lot more sort of, the first time I saw you, I thought it was like a session band, but it's a lot more sort of
camaraderie
than that.
No, we're all really close.
Yeah.
It's like, I don't know.
I used to live with Sam and Olivia for like 2 years before and stuff. But
was this when you were in Bath?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So did you meet the university sort of thing, or is it?
No, we met Olivia because me, Callum and Olivia used to work in the same music shop years ago. We met Charlie and Sam both through my girlfriend. We were just looking for players and they knew it. And I sent them both very creepy messages on Facebook. And it came around.
Charlie actually said no.
Yeah, Charlie said no because I was too polite.
Yeah.
And then I had to talk him, convince him that it wasn't going to be as bad as I made out.
We're like, it's turned out all right. And like the album came out on the 18th of August. But one thing I find quite funny is you're going at the whole wages as a single just being pushed at the moment.
Yeah.
It was Annie Mac's hottest single in 2016, and now it's Greg James's track of the week. Does it feel a bit weird to be going through the same...
We're just hoping for Radio 6 in 2020.
With the same song.
We're just going to keep releasing.
Yeah.
I don't know, it's just the way the industry works.
Yeah.
It's not...
I think it's weird because it was basically like that song was the song that kind of started everything for it. Avalanche kind of got our name about, but I feel like Wages is a lot of the song that people first discovered us through. Like it was over FIFA and people just seemed to really attach to that song.
I think it's that big like horn at the start.
Sure.
Is that a song that you drew from something?
It's just inspired by we listen to a lot of like 60s and 70s soul music.
Okay.
And it's kind of a cliche.
I was thinking more like Find the Streams.
Oh really? Yeah.
You know that song Loaded, the Andy Weatherall mix?
Sure, yeah.
I was thinking that, like...
No, it's funny actually, like, we We did have that a lot when we first started, when we just had like Avalanche and Wages and we did get like some people saying we were like baggy and stuff, and we were like, what the hell is baggy? And had to like look it
up. What is baggy?
Like, you know, like that kind of sound.
Okay.
Like,
yeah.
That and like Happy Mondays and stuff, which I do really like.
Okay.
That stuff.
Yeah.
But I think we, for us, that influence came more out of like Beck and like the Dust Brothers and Beastie Boys.
Okay.
And also like soul music.
It's that thing when you take a live, when you take what is predominantly a live thing and add these sort of synthesized and, you know, you add in these sound elements to it.
Yeah, yeah.
One thing I think that's interesting about your gigs is they come out more as party. People don't stand still at your gigs.
Yeah.
And there are bands that have, you know, equivalent energy, they are good quality bands. But you put quite a lot of effort into the production value of your whole show.
Yeah, yeah.
You don't just have a random playlist going, you turn it up high and you have bangers.
Yeah.
Is that a deliberate choice?
Yeah, of course, yeah. It's like when we started making music, Ewan didn't want to do live gigs at all because we just, I think growing up playing in bands as well, we were guitarists and
yeah.
And the kids. We've seen too many gigs where you just like go and watch some people trying to be cool as they can.
Yeah.
Just playing their guitars.
And people
like,
standing there like, I'm here to watch the band.
Yeah, exactly. And like nobody's really that into it.
No.
Apart from the band.
Yeah.
And it was just a real big deal for us to try and make it as inclusive as possible and as positive as possible. And just like, you know, just a real, I don't want to say party and I don't want to say experience, but it's just something that is fun regardless of the music.
Yeah, well, it's that thing I've thought about this a lot. We're starting our own like event series, but the idea isn't ever to push the band. It's to push the whole experience
yeah.
in the way you buy tickets to a night out.
Yeah,
people
sure,
who spend
yeah.
like £10 to get into a club have no idea what that means.
Yeah, sure.
And they'll have a great time and they'll all dance.
Yeah.
And I think that you sort of straddle that line quite interestingly. What happened to the light up dance floor that you used to tour with? Is that still about?
Oh, we only did have two shows.
Did you?
But it, was, like, it became like a bit legendary. But
I mean, it has to.
It was.
It's
that deep.
People know about it now, but the only thing was at the shows, like both shows, everybody else was like, oh, this venue's really cool, isn't it? It's got a light dance floor. Like, no, we brought that.
We brought that.
This venue sucks.
Yeah, what? Yeah. Have you brought anything? They didn't even want us to do it because it would take too much power.
It's a nightmare.
Have you brought anything on this tour? Some of the pictures from earlier shows have shown balloons.
Yeah,
we've got a few kind of, so we really wanted to play on the like, the Get Better, like self-help thing
yeah.
in the album. So there's a lot of stuff around that. We kind of like, I don't want to like give too much away, but we kind of like framed the evening as like a self-help clinic.
Guys, thank you so much for your time.
Pleasure.
Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
I got a cold coffee, yeah.
Have you got anything for Halloween stuff?
Obviously,
this
won't
be going out today.
We do. It's going to be quite a horrible though. I was sort of warning. It's not a kind of horror. It's not like horror. It's just
horrible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
happy.
Yeah. Is this going to be okay for the younger fans?
Well, that's what I'm worried about.
Yeah, I don't know. We will find out.
Yeah.
It's Sam I'm most nervous about. Yeah, we'll see.
We got some footage of that later.
Thank you
so much.
No way.